my dear friends, how many of you like listening to stories? Great. So let's make many. I have a double feast for you today with not one but two stories. And how many of you like listening to love stories? So let's start with a love story. A beautiful story of two people madly, deeply in love. Riya, a beautiful, pretty looking young girl, and Rehan, a handsome hunk. So today, it's a very important day in Riya's life. She's waiting for Rehan, for whom she's fought with almost everybody in her family. She's annoyed her loving dad. She's fought with her mother just to let this guy come into her life. He is expected to be at their house to meet the parents at 4 o'clock. It's already past 5. And so Rehan is not around. Any noise, and her gaze goes towards the entry gate. But alas, it's not Rehan. It's not Rehan again. Her dad showing her the watch. Riya, do you really think he cares for you? What could be more important than this meeting? Do you really think he values you the way you do for him? Riya has no answer. She's sad and angry at the same time. Sorrow, shame, disappointment, all the feelings coming to her, and she's staring at her phone. Rehan has not been even answering her calls for last 1 hour or so. Rehan, where the hell are you? No, I'm not listening to anything. Even today you have something important which has come up. This meeting is not important for you, Rehan. No, I'm not listening to you anything. None of your stories today. Next 10 minutes, if you're not here, Rehan, you might lose me. And she's not answering her calls, his calls anymore. Sad. So this was a story of a loving and caring Riya and a callous and insensitive Rehan, right? Maybe not. Story 1, scene 2. The phone rings again. Before Riya starts, a firm voice stops her. Riya, this is Dr. Gaurav Gupta from Manipal Hospital. We've been trying to reach you for the last half an hour, but there were no calls attended, so I had to call you from a different number. We have this gentleman who came into our hospital sometime back with a ring in one hand and a rose in the other. He's met with an accident and he had multiple head injuries, and only thing he wanted was talk to you for one last time. Let's move on. Story 2, scene 1. Mr. and Mrs. Gupta have moved to a new apartment. Mrs. Gupta is just checking out her house. She's really happy about the how large the house is, how airy the house is. She opens up the window and sees her neighbor drying her clothes in a balcony, and she screams towards Mr. Gupta, "Oh my God, look at them!" She doesn't even know how to wash clothes. She's drying it and it's already dirty. Mr. Gupta is gazing at his newspaper and notes before even he hears, and then processes the message and ignores it. The same story happens again and again for rest few days, and every time the neighbor is struggling to wash the clothes properly. So Mrs. Gupta has a lot of suggestions. Maybe she should change her soap. Maybe she should take training from a person like me and whatnot. One fine morning on a Sunday, she again peeps out of the window and sees, "Honey, I think Our neighbor has changed her detergent. The clothes look so cleaner today. Mr. Gupta, his husband says, no honey, in fact I got up early today and I cleaned our window. So friends, how many times do we conclude or come to a judgment without even listening to the other side of the story? Without even seeing the whole picture, we form our judgments. Does it happen to everyone every single day?
Yes.
So how do we resolve it? How do we stop ourselves? Because what I believe is how you see defines what you see. So it's you are the source. So based on whatever trainings I've got, books I've read, or whatever little experience I have, I want to share some nuggets, some learnings of my life which might help all of you. So the moment we go to the first point, I want to introduce you to somebody. So this is a person who's been with you all your life. He's the person who manipulates all your thoughts and makes you do things you don't even imagine. I'm not talking about your spouses. I'm talking about a person who's right now sitting on your shoulders and whispering in your ears. What the hell is this man talking about? Yes, I'm talking about your inner voice, your subconscious voice. The moment you are talking to somebody, even before he starts talking, you're listening. Doesn't that happen? So the process is actually called already and always listening. So this subconscious or the inner voice is always whispering into your ears. So what happens is, even without listening to the person you're talking to, you're already in your thoughts. How can you be an authentic listener if you're already and always listening? But the moment you are present to the fact that this is not what he's saying, that is the point you become an authentic listener. So that is one of the very important points. Second point I want to bring about is, I'm sure whenever we see somebody, we form an opinion. Without even interacting, without even going closer to him, the way it is called 12 meter judgment, before he comes 12 feet or 12 inches closer to you, we already have an opinion. What is it? So the idea is, I see Prakash and I form an opinion. He is from this place, so he is like this. He comes, he talks like this, so he must be like this. So that is my thought. But the moment we realize that you are not your thought, because thoughts are unstable, thoughts are temporary, thoughts are your employees, you are not governed by thoughts. So you are not your thought. The moment you come to that distinction and you step aside and you're able to see, this is my thought, but I don't think or I'm not identifying with it, the moment you do that, you become a better listener. Point number three is, when we talk to somebody, we always put them on our autobiography scale. So if he's saying this, I understand because I have gone through this. So you're actually matching up or scaling them to your own autobiography. Stephen Covey, in his book, he talks about seek first to understand, then to be understood. So the moment you understand the person you are listening to, then only you can actually relate with him rather than putting him into your own life and measuring him. So you have to understand him, only then you can be a better listener. So with that, I come to the final point, which talks about looking at the complete picture. Of course, in most of the times we listen to one story and we human beings are all emotional. So we hear one story and form our opinion without even listening to the other story. Like I gave you a story of Priya, I'm sure there were opinions formed. I gave you a story of Mrs. Gupta, I'm sure there were opinions formed without even listening to the whole story. But the idea is, the moment we employ these things, that you are not your thought, you have to understand who you are listening to. And the very first point, what was it?
Already and always listening.
Already and always listening. So the moment you are present to all these things, you would be a better listener, you would be a better person, which would give you the power to take decisions, to resolve issues in a much, much better light. In the end, I would just like to say, a famous line from Mirza Ghalib. He says, "Umr bhar Ghalib yahi galti karta raha, dhool chehre pe thi aur main aaina saaf karta." That's it.